Welcome back to Orlando Matters. I'm Keith Landry. Now we've got an interesting charity group for you, a way for you to get involved and make a difference. Wayne Elsey is the founder and CEO of Souls for Souls. It's a group that collects shoes and distributes them to people in need. Novel idea. And I want to thank you for being here this Saturday morning, and I want to thank you for coming on and sharing what you're doing. What is Souls for Souls, and why did you start it?
You know, Keith, Souls for Souls is a very interesting charity. At the end of the day, what we do is we get and we distribute shoes to people in need. And that could be somebody right here in Orlando. It could be somebody in Haiti. I just got back yesterday from Haiti, where we've distributed over 1.5 million pairs of shoes.
Since when?
Since 2004. Literally, I was sitting on a couch like this, and I saw this single shoe float up on the shore during the Asian tsunami.
Really?
And it bothered me, and I was an executive in the shoe industry at the time, and you know, I said, why don't I do something about this? Why don't I collect shoes for people that need them? So we collected shoes, and 8 weeks later, we sent over 250,000 pairs of shoes to Southeast Asia.
Really?
So you fast forward to today, every 7 seconds, we're distributing a pair of shoes in 127 different countries.
Really? Wow.
It's crazy.
Where's the need? The need's everywhere, right?
You know, the need is not too far. You know, I just had somebody in the green room ask me, you know, is there any need in Orlando? I said, absolutely.
Yeah.
I said, we've distributed thousands of pairs of shoes here because people are hurting.
Yeah.
You know, a pair of shoes can make a difference in somebody's life in a big way. It can help them look forward. It may be the answer to them getting a job.
Or when you got to decide if you're going to pay the electrical bill or
That's
get
right.
food or get your child a pair of shoes, you're going to go for the food and the electric bill because you have to.
That's exactly right. We did a distribution right here in Orlando a couple of years ago, and I saw a child with duct tape over the end of the shoes, and I asked him, what is that all about? And he said, my mom couldn't afford a new pair of shoes.
Yeah.
That he needed a size 12. He had a size 10 on.
Wow. Unbelievable. So how can folks get involved?
You know, it's really easy. You can go to our website at giveshoes.org, and there's all kinds of ways, whether you want to fundraise, whether you want to collect shoes, whether you want to drop off shoes. You can actually enter in your zip code. It'll tell you our local drop-off points here all around the country, local drop points right here in Orlando. You can enter a zip code to tell you where to take your shoes locally.
Tax deductible?
Tax deductible. Clean your closets out.
Yeah, no kidding. I've got a bunch of old shoes in there. What about, where do you go from here? What's the goal? What's the vision for the future?
You know, I it's funny you say that because I'm right in the middle of a whole strategic planning process now with our board. And I think that, you know, I want to distribute a pair of shoes every second. And then I want to distribute two pair of shoes every second and really just turn the clock around. I've told my team that we will be a billion-dollar charity in 10 years, that we continue doing this. We're one of the fastest-growing charities right now with something so simple as a pair of shoes.
Wayne, I've been doing TV news for almost 22 years in 7 states across the United States. There are no people on the planet who are more giving and generous than the American people. Have you seen that?
Absolutely. You know, we all, you know, have it well. You know, again, I just got back from Haiti, and, you know, somebody made a comment to me, well, these people seem like they're doing okay. All the children have school uniforms on, and they have shoes on. I said, yeah, but you know what? It costs $25 a year to go to school in Haiti. And I said, these kids are still sleeping in filth. They're still sleeping on the ground. They don't have anything near to what we have.
What are you doing for the holidays? Is there a big push coming up for the holidays or anything like that?
Huge. Every year in Oviedo, Dr. Biblowitz here in town, Michael Biblowitz, the ear, nose, and throat doctor, does a big thing with a local enterprise here that we're giving away, I think, 15,000 pair of shoes and stuffed animals and stuff like that. And we're going to do the same thing, different footprints all around the country, doing the same thing, giving back. Because, you know, there's still unemployment at 9.1%. It's not getting any better. People are hurting. And if we, like you said, can offset some of that expense that mom and dad have to pay by giving them a pair of shoes for the kids, sign us up.
You know, there's nothing worse than a kid who has to go to school with a raggedy pair of shoes and the other kids are picking on them.
That's right.
Everybody just wants to be accepted and to be able to focus on the things they're at school to do.
That's right. Well, you know, the bullying thing in schools. I mean, there's enough things for kids to worry about. They don't need to worry about having, you know, Buster Brownish pairs of shoes or whatever that the kids don't have. So.
Yeah. Let's talk about your book. It looks like you got a new book here that you wanted to mention.
Yeah, Almost Isn't Good Enough. You know, literally, this goes back to December 26, 2004, when I was sitting on the couch, where I believe that I had a whisper and said, hey, you need to do something about this. And it kind of walks through the transition of me going from corporate America to a philanthropist. And the return on investment in people's lives is so much more important than the return on investment in corporate America. And it's my challenge to people. And I donate 100% of the proceeds back to the charity. And matter of fact, in the book at the end, you know, when you after you read the book and you pay for the book, you can donate 10 pair of shoes.
Oh, nice.
You know, right there. So you go to our website and donate 10 pair of shoes for the cost of the book.
Huh.
But it's cool. It's changing people's lives. And the cool thing about it, when I flew in this week from Haiti, somebody was actually reading my book on the plane.
Really?
And it's cool that people are really responding and sending me emails and letters and pictures about things they're doing in their local community.
All right, so let's mention the website one more time before I let you go.
Yeah, giveshoes.org.
And what will people find there?
They will find a wealth of information. They'll find videos, interactive ways they can get plugged into Souls for Souls. Or if they just want to have coloring sheets for their kids. You know, one of my big pushes is teaching kids about social responsibility. Mm-hmm. So there's actual coloring sheets where mom can sit down and say, hey, you know what, little Johnny in Haiti or Africa or in Atlanta doesn't have a pair of shoes, and here's how you can make a difference.
Wayne LCV, founder and CEO of Souls for Souls, thank you. Thanks for making a difference. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
It's good work you're doing.
Thank you, Keith.
You bet. Take a quick break. Orlando Matters continues after we pay a couple bills because we got to keep the lights off.